Okay, so again, good morning to everyone. So for today, we will just be finishing our discussion with hematopoiesis. So I will be ending with erythropoiesis. So your final score, okay, your final score is already the score you've seen. So I have no corrections or manual checking that I need to do. So nandun na lahat ng answers. So you can actually check it later by the end of our period. Okay? By the end of our period, you can check the correct answers already. So for this morning, we will be continuing on our discussion, which is your hematopoiesis. So it's very important for us to realize, okay, that there are two theories when it comes to how hematopoiesis happen within the body. I say theory because up until now, okay, there is still no absolute evidence that will point out that one theory is the one that is correct versus the other. Okay, so let me just clear that. So up until now, both are just theory, but the scientific community are leaning onto one of this theory of hematopoiesis. So there are actually two theories of hematopoiesis, okay? Two theories of hematopoiesis, which is your monophyletic theory of hematopoiesis. So according to the monophyletic theory of hematopoiesis, all blood cells are derived from a single progenitor stem cell, which is a pluripotent hematopoietic stem cell. So monophyletic states that this pluripotent stem cell multiply to produce more pluripotent stem cell, which will be discussed later on the type of division for your stem cells. Okay, for your stem cell. I hope everyone's mind is already aligned with hematopoiesis. So hematopoiesis, let's go back again, is the process of blood cell production. Okay, blood cell production. So according to monophyletic theory, sabi sa monophyletic theory, your white blood cell, your red blood cells, your megakaryocyte that eventually gives rise to your platelets came from one cell. Okay, and that is a pluripotent hematopoietic stem cell, meaning to say this pluripotent hematopoietic stem cell can differentiate into those different precursor. Okay, they can differentiate from being a pluripotent hematopoietic stem cell, magiging erythroblast sila, magiging myeloid precursor, or magiging lymphoid precursor. Yun yung ibig sabihin nun. From one cell, it will give rise to different cells depending on its differentiation. Another theory that is being proposed is also your polyphyletic theory. What do we mean by poly? By its root, by its word poly, meaning to say many. Okay, so they believe that each blood cell lineages is derived from its own unique stem cell. So according to this theory, the platelets has its own hematopoietic stem cell, your red blood cells has its own precursor cell, your WBC, your basophil, your eosinophil, your lymphocytes, your monocytes, your neutrophils, all of them are having their own, okay, their own stem cell. Okay, but between these two, pakikitandaan po, please write it down on your notes because this might be coming out of the exam. So between these two, which is favored by the scientific community, anyone? Alin dito yung pinapaboran nila? They agree that this theory is actually how hematopoiesis happen. Anybody from the chat in the chat box? Is it the mono or the poly? Correct. Okay. Walang sumasagot sa akin. It's the monophyletic. Okay. If you have read your RODOC already, okay. If you have read RODOC already, it's found on page 52 of the 2020 edition. They are actually favoring the monophyletic theory. Okay. The monophyletic theory. Okay, so let us go now to your hematopoietic stem cells, okay? Hematopoietic stem cells. So, a while back, last time, we discussed already what apoptosis is. Now, we will be discussing what self-renewal is, differentiation, and the types of division. So, your hematopoietic stem cell can has three fate, okay? Meron siyang tatlong destination. It can either go self-renewal, differentiation, or apoptosis, okay? We already know that apoptosis is the programmed cell death, which is also part of your quiz, okay? It is a physiological cell death that are induced by either different cytokines or chemicals within your cell, within your body, or simply the deprivation of those growth factors will cause their death, okay? So, will cause their death. What I want to focus on is the fate of your stem cell, be it its self-renewal and differentiation. Okay? Be it self-renewal and differentiation. Before I explain it further, let me go ahead and talk about the types of division. Okay? The types of division can be symmetric or asymmetric. Okay? So when we say, symmetric, okay, the daughter cell are both, both of them will be, when we say symmetric, both of the cell will undergo differentiation. But if one cell, but only one cell lang ang magdi-differentiate and the other one will return into the pool as to do self-renewal, we call that asymmetric. I know it's parang, if you haven't read the book, it doesn't make sense, okay? If you came here in class today and you haven't read the book, it parang medyo nakakalito pa siya, okay? But let me try to explain it to you. I'll present my screen, okay? Wait lang ha. I'll connect and then gagawa tayo ng diagram, okay? Hopefully, this diagram will help you understand how it happens, okay? So, yan, I'm already in the meeting. So, can somebody confirm, ha, if you can already see my screen? There. Can you see my screen now?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay. Yung screen ng iPad, ha? Okay. Thank you so much. So, sabi natin kanina, your hematopoietic stem cell has three fate. Okay? Meron siyang tatlong fate, which is to differentiate, to self-renew, okay, self-renewal, and apoptosis, okay? So, alam na natin lahat yan, okay? So, take for example, I have here, okay? I think I will best explain it using a diagram. So, take for example, this is your hematopoietic stem cell. Your hematopoietic stem cell will give rise to two daughter cells, okay? To two daughter cells. So, this is its daughter cell, okay? I will call them D1 and D2, okay? These are their D daughter cell, okay? Take for example, I cannot zoom it out kasi, sorry. So, let me just try to go to, ano na lang, here, ayan. So, take for example, this is your hematopoietic stem cell. Okay? So, this is your hematopoietic stem cell. This is your HSC. Okay? Your hematopoietic stem cell. It will now give rise to two daughter cell. Okay? Two daughter cell. And we will call them D1 and D2. Okay? So, as what we were mentioning a while back, your hematopoietic stem cell has three fate, either to go apoptosis, but that's not the topic for now, or it can go differentiation or self-renewal. Take for example, both of this daughter cell, okay, both of this daughter cell underwent differentiation. We call this process now as your symmetric, okay? The division is symmetric. Are we clear? The division is symmetric. So kung pareha sila ng pinuntahan, both of them differentiated, we call it symmetric. Are we clear? Hello?
Yes, okay. Po, sir.
We call it symmetric. Sir, what about the other one? Okay? Take for example, okay? Take for example, D1 and D2. Okay, D1 and D2. One cell will undergo differentiation and the other cell will return to the pool that is called now your self-renewal. Okay? This process now is asymmetric division. Are we clear? Kung yung isa nag-proceed to differentiate, yung isa naman bumalik sa pool, okay? So take for example, this is the pool of your hematopoietic stem cell, bumalik siya doon to replenish the number of hematopoietic stem cell, that is now your self-renewal. And kung yung isa nag-self-renew, yung isa nag-differentiate, we call that asymmetric. Are we clear? Clear po tayo? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is also the way of your, maybe some of you are wondering, sir, paano po na, how can we make sure, how can the bone marrow make sure that it will never run out of hematopoietic stem cell? The answer is asymmetric cell division. Okay? Asymmetric type of division. One will own, when there is two, okay, when there is two types, when there is two daughter cell, one will go to, into further differentiation. So when I say differentiation, mamaya pag-uusapan natin, it can either become an erythroid precursor, a myeloid precursor, or a lymphoid precursor. Are we clear? So yun lang muna yung gusto kong isettle kasi kailangan ninyong mag-grasp itong idea na to that your hematopoietic stem cell can go into three phases: apoptosis, cell differentiation, and self-renewal. Apoptosis, we explained it a while back as the programmed cell death. Okay? Differentiation, what do we mean by differentiation, sir? Differentiation means it will undergo further differentiation to become now your blood cells. Are we clear? Another thing is self-renewal. Self-renewal, the daughter cell will return to the pool of hematopoietic stem cell. Sir, why? This is the process, this is the way of your bone marrow to make sure that there will be enough hematopoietic stem cell in the course of your life. Are we clear? Clear po tayo doon?
Yes po.
Okay. So I hope that's clear ha, na kapag both of them differentiated, symmetric. Ibig sabihin, pareha sila ng destination. But if one differentiated, the other one underwent self-renewal, that is called your asymmetric cell division. Okay? So moving forward, maybe some of you, sir, I just wonder, when will be the time that the bone marrow will realize that it's time to do self-renewal or when to do symmetric and when to do asymmetric? Haven't you wondered how? So the process is now, can you see the PowerPoint now? Can you see my PowerPoint now?
Yes po.
Okay. So maybe some of you are wondering how did it happen. That is actually through your models now of hematopoiesis. We have your stochastic, we have your instructive, okay? And we have your multi-lineage priming model. So in your book, it is actually very much defined the two models, your stochastic and your instructive. Sir, when will my hematopoietic stem cell know kung kailan siya mag-asymmetric at magsisymmetric? The answer is here. It's either stochastic or instructive. When we say stochastic, okay, your stochastic model of hematopoiesis is actually a random selection. So your cells randomly commit to self-renewal or differentiation. Okay? It either random lang yung selection nun. Okay? Random lang yung selection nun. So self-renewal or it will differentiate. Okay? It's self-renewal or differentiate. So that part, okay, in that particular part of your your hematopoiesis that is random. Stochastic po siya. Okay? Stochastic yung tawag. But what about your instructive? Okay? When we say instructive, remember we have your bone marrow microenvironment. Okay? Remember the bone marrow microenvironment, yung tinawag natin na stromal cells, the endothelial cells, the macrophages, osteoclasts, osteoblasts, and then also yung mga soluble substances. Ayan, itong mga to. I hope you still remember that. Okay? This particular part is playing a big part on the instructive hematopoiesis. And the instructive hematopoiesis, your bone marrow microenvironment, determine now if your stem cell will self-renew or differentiate. Okay? If they will undergo self-renewal, or if they are going to differentiate into a particular type of cell. So between these two, scientists believe that the initial decision to self-renew or differentiate is probably stochastic. Okay, it is probably stochastic. So kung magre-renew ba yan or magde-differentiate, it's random. But it is very much known that when it starts to differentiate, the process now becomes instructive. Bakit po instructive, sir? Because later on, when we discuss, there are particular substances. I think you remember one, like your erythropoietin. Your erythropoietin influences now your differentiated cell. Take for example, I'm just gonna take the erythropoietin. Take for example, it is your erythropoietin that influences the differentiated cell. It will now influence the cell into becoming a red blood cell. So, ganun siya. Sir, is that the same thing with WBC, with megakaryocytes? Yes. So later on, we will be talking about the colony-forming unit, the colony-stimulating factors, GEMM, and you also have other colony-stimulating factors as we go along. Okay? Meron pang isa. Okay? So alam na natin ha, stochastic, instructive, and we also have your multi-lineage priming model. So the cell's fate is determined by internal and external factor. This is now part of your hematopoietic inductive microenvironment. But to be more specific, okay, this is actually now because of the amplification or repression of your genes. Okay, yung mga genes po natin, we're going to DNA now. Okay, so sir, can you help us to differentiate this tree model? Okay, let's do this. When we are talking about stochastic, we are talking about what? Random. Okay, they are randomly committed to self-renewal or differentiation. Ito, this is the model when it comes to being asymmetric or symmetric. Are we clear? It's stochastic, random. When we say instructive, by the root word of instructive, instruct, meaning to say somebody instructed your cells now to differentiate further. And where does that instructions coming from? It comes from the bone marrow microenvironment. Are we still clear? Malinaw pa po ba ako?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. So ganun siya ha. So parang take for example, yung makakasalubong mo every single day, okay, yung makakasalubong mo every single day sa jeep, that is stochastic. You don't know whoever will you be coming into contact with. Okay? But when it comes to instructive, take for example, I instructed that all 3-MeO3 will pass through this. Okay? There is a certain instruction. Okay? There's a certain influence instruction given to you guys. So all of you will follow that. Ganun din si cell. So they can influence the cell by giving off cytokines and colony stimulating factors, which I will be discussing later on. Kalma lang, okay? Huwag magpapanik. So basta ang point ko lang, may instructions, okay? May mga signals, may chemical signals that influence your bone marrow to become who will they become in the future. In the multi-lineage priming model, okay, what I want you to remember here are your genes, your G-E-N-E-S, your genes, either a repressed or an amplified gene, okay? So, ayun siya, okay? So, here, on the other hand, okay, so let me just dig deeper with the multi-lineage priming model. Dito, okay, yung mga genes natin within our body, within the DNA, influences your microenvironment as well. So, sila yung magsasabi palalo na, oh, ito yung ilabas mo palalo. Ito yung huwag mo munang ilabas para mag-focus tayo sa pag-produce ng ganitong bagay. So, that is how the dose model is happening. Are we clear so far? Clear pa po tayo? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I hope, I want you to have a strong concept when it comes to the faith, the cell division, and the model. Okay? So hopefully, you also did draw on your part. Okay? Para mas maintindihan nyo siya. Sometimes, I don't need you guys to narrate to me Rodak verbatim. What I want is to hear your actual answers. Okay? To hear your actual answers. So, take for example, what is symmetric and what is asymmetric? Yung mga ganong drama. Okay? So that is self-renewal, differentiation, and apoptosis, your asymmetric and symmetric, your stochastic instructive in the multi-lineage priming model. Okay? So let's go now to your stem cell cycle kinetics. Okay? Your stem cell cycle kinetics. So every single day, okay, every single day, your bone marrow produces 2.5 billion of erythrocytes, 2.5 billion platelets, and 1 billion granulocytes per kilogram of body weight daily. So imagine that, okay? Imagine that. And to tell you honestly, one of the key factor that controls the rate of your fish, the rate of production is your physiologic need. Makikitandaan po ako, mga kapatid, it is your physiologic need. Okay? What do we mean by physiologic need? Yung pangangailangan ng sarili mo. Okay, I've been seeing ano daw yung kailangan unahin, red tap or purple tap. Kailangan mo daw unahin yung sarili mo. So that is how your body is responding. Okay? They respond according to the need of your body. Take for example, you are in a environment na deprived sa oxygen, your body now will tend to, take for example, there's hypoxia, your body now will tend to produce more red blood cells so that there will be more hemoglobin in your body. Take for example, you have infection, there is parasite, bacteria, or virus that is inside your body's response to that physiologic need is to produce more of your white blood cells. Are you getting me? Kuha po tayo? Okay.
Yes po.
So, when it comes to our when it comes to stem cell kinetics, it's very important for you guys to remember that the normal mitotic index is 1 to 2%. Okay, 1 to 2%. So imagine that, no, that your mitotic index is only 1 to 2%. Okay, I will not be discussing PMAT already here. So this is your G1, your S phase, and your G2, your G0, which is the resting, and then eventually your yan yung G1, S1, yung S and yung G2 phase natin before it undergo your mitosis. Makikireview lang tayo what are the different phases of mitosis. Chat box. What are the different phases of mitosis? The P is? What is the P? Okay, wala. Prophase, metaphase, ayan, o, diba? Naging keyboard warrior na po si Miss Martin. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Okay, PMAT. And please remember that your interphase is not part of the cell division proper. Okay? The interface kasi is actually part of yung G2. Okay? Sa G2 siya. Okay? So, Ayan yung sa interface. Interface is the preparation of your cell before undergoing mitosis. So again, ha, guys, please remember that your mitotic index is only 1 to 2%. Sir, what if it becomes 5%? Meaning there is an abnormal, there is an increased cell proliferation. So what do we mean by that? Mas mataas daw yung pagde-divide ng cell mo. Okay? And an increased mitotic index now would imply that there is increased proliferation within your body. So understanding now your stem cell cycle kinetics, okay? Your stem cell cycle kinetics, dito na ngayon magfo-fall kung bakit nagtataka kayo. But kaya alam ng mga doctors, take for example yung mga may leukemia, when to give a particular part or when to give this type of chemotherapy or chemotherapeutic drug to a patient, okay? They know that based on their mitotic index, okay? Based on the mitotic index. So kanina nyo pa ako siguro naririnig that there are specific cytokines, okay? There are specific cytokines that are influencing the rate of mitosis. There are cytokines that influence the differentiation of a particular cell. So what are cytokines? Okay? So cytokines, okay, are soluble proteins that are hematopoietic growth factors, okay? So when we say hematopoietic growth factors and cytokines, they are synonymous, mga kapatid, okay? Cytokines and hematopoietic growth factors, they are one and the same. So what do? They regulate, okay? They regulate the proliferation, the differentiation, and the maturation of your hematopoietic precursor cell. Once again, they regulate the proliferation, the differentiation, and the maturation of your hematopoietic stem cell, okay? Or your hematopoietic precursor cells, okay? So there are a few here. This is IL, okay? When I say IL, these are your interleukins, okay? These are your interleukins. So obviously, we have your lymphokines, we have your monokines, we have your interferons, your chemokines, and your colony stimulating factors, okay? Your colony stimulating factors. So please do remember, okay? Please do remember that when it comes to cytokines, when it comes to the cytokines that influences your differentiation, there can be two major differentiation that can either be a positive influence or a negative influence cytokine. So what do we mean by that? When we say positive influence on the hematopoietic stem cell, they promote the differentiation, they promote the maturation, they promote the proliferation. Okay, so I'll just gonna give you the ano ha. So on the chat box, okay, I posted there that hematopoietic growth factor or cytokines are the one that regulate the proliferation, differentiation, and maturation. When we say positive, okay, it actually favors the proliferation, the differentiation, and the maturation of your hematopoietic stem cell. When we say negative naman, okay, it's the opposite, obviously. When we say negative, it hampers or it limits the proliferation, the differentiation, and the maturation of your stem cell. Are we clear?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. So, ayan siya, ha? So, moving forward now, in your book, there are actually several cytokines that will influence your hematopoiesis positively or negatively, okay? Positively or negatively. So that is actually found on page 54, okay? Page 54 to 56, okay? Page 54 to 56. Just for the sake of discussion, the cytokines and growth factors are very important, okay? They have a diverse group, and I am not expecting you to memorize each of the growth factors that influence them, okay? But they're actually main, okay? We have main cytokines and colony stimulating factors that you guys need to remember. Okay? So, take for example, okay, I'm just gonna paste it on the chat box. Okay? So, we have a positive, those that positively influence your hematopoietic stem cell are as follows. Your KIT ligand, your FL3 ligand, your GM-CFU, so that is your granulocyte, myeloid, megakaryocyte colony stimulating factors, your interleukin 1, 3, 6, and 11. And you also have your negative cytokines, okay? That includes your growth factor beta, your tumor necrosis factor alpha, and your interferons. Sir, that is, where can we read that? You can read that on page 54 to 56. Okay, page 54 to 56. So when we told you guys that you need to go to your book, it's still very important. Okay, so explain ko lang ng mabilis ha. Your cytokines, okay, your cytokines and growth factors, sabi nga natin kanina, they regulate your proliferation, differentiation, and maturation of your different precursor cell. So these cytokines are really diverse, okay? They are diverse when it comes to their classification, but most of them are actually positively influencing your hematopoiesis. And the examples are on the chat box already. So you have your KIT ligand, your FL3 ligand, your GM-CSF, your interleukin 1, 3, 6, and 11. Okay? So, these cytokines, okay? So, these cytokines naman, okay? On the other hand, yung mga nasa negative, they prevent, okay? They prevent yung differentiation, yung proliferation, and maturation of your cells. Okay? Maturation of your cells. So, clear pa ba tayo? Are you still there?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay. So, moving forward now. Okay, moving forward. Let's go on. So, your human stem cell now. Okay, your human stem cell, sabi natin kanina, di ba? That, in case that I do not finish this discussion, huwag kayo mag-alala, I will record na lang, I will record the part that I did not finish. Roughly siguro mga ilang slides lang naman ito, if ever, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like ano lang, less than 10 pa lang siya. Although para hindi tayo mag-extend, okay, so we won't be extending, I will just be sending you guys a recorded slide of this discussion. And by the way, it's already been set the final coverage of your hematology is from skin, from the beginning until erythropoiesis. Okay, erythropoiesis. So yeah, let's move on. So your human stem cell has three types, sabi ko nga, diba? Meron tayong totipotential stem cell, which is present in the first few hours after an ovum is fertilized. So this is the most versatile. Okay, this is the most versatile type of stem cell because it can develop into any human cell type. Okay, we have your pluripotential stem cell on the other hand. This is now present several days after fertilization, and this can develop into any cell type as well. Okay. We also have here your multipotential stem cell. This is derived now from your pluripotent stem cell. Okay? It came from your pluripotent stem cell. And this is found in adults but are limited in specific types of cell to form your tissue. Okay? Example natin dyan is your bone marrow. Your bone marrow stem cell can give rise to blood cells, bone cartilage, and your adipose cell. Okay? Adipose cell. So, these are the three types of human stem cell. But what we're going to talk about here, okay, alone is your, what? What we're going to talk about here is your hematopoietic stem cell. Your hematopoietic stem cell is a multipotent stem cell. Are we clear? A multipotent stem cell. So type 3 siya. Okay? Pang so your hematopoietic stem cell are multipotent stem cell that give rise now to all blood types. Cell types including your myeloid and your lymphoid. Okay? Wait lang. Explain ko lang ito ng mabilis. Your hematopoietic stem cell can differentiate into two. Ito na po yung sinasabi natin kanina na differentiation. It can differentiate into two. It can differentiate into becoming a myeloid precursor or a lymphoid precursor. Sir, dalawa lang? Yes, dalawa lang. Your myeloid precursor can give rise to your GEM or your granulocyte, erythrocyte, your monocyte, and your megakaryocyte. Okay? So, makikisulat ako, ha? Okay? Your myeloid, okay? Your myeloid can give rise to your GEM. Your GEM stands for your granulocyte, okay? What are the different granulocytes? That is your neutrophil, eosinophil, and your basophil. We also have your erythrocytes, okay? It can also give rise to your erythrocytes, to your monocytes, and your megakaryocyte. Megakaryocyte. Maybe some of you are wondering, sir, bakit po hinahiwalay si monocyte? Because remember, your monocyte is a granulocytic cell. Okay? Wala siyang granules. Are we clear? Can you still remember that? Ay, yung granulocytic and a granulocyte and granulocytes. Okay? So, on the other hand, we have your lymphoid naman, okay? Your lymphoid precursor. Your lymphoid precursor now will give rise to your lymphocytes, obviously, your natural killer cells or your NK cells, and also your natural killer cells. And yan, lymphocyte and natural killer cell. Are we clear? Hello? Clear pa po tayo?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Okay. So ganun yung kwento niya, 'di ba? So later on, siguro before I end, mamaya I'll try to wrap it up all together. Okay? So pakikitandaan lang that your hematopoietic stem cell can differentiate into two, okay? Into two main, your myeloid and your lymphoid. Okay? Your myeloid and your lymphoid. Okay? So moving forward now, okay, moving forward, these cells can be obtained directly by removal from the hip, okay? So, sabi natin kanina, di ba, yung mga stem cell natin can either be aspirated for testing. Kanina in your quiz, there was a choice there. Meron kang proximal long bone, tapos meron kang iliac crest. Your iliac crest is part of your pelvis, okay, or your pelvic bone. Between the two, you need to choose which is the best, okay? Which is the best site for bone marrow collection. And the answer there will be your iliac crest or your pelvic bone. Okay? So, these now are being aspirated by a needle. Yes, sir. Being aspirated po siya using your needle. So, ginagrind yung bone mo para makapasok sa bone marrow. So, at the same time, okay, so using needle and syringe or from the blood following pre-treatment with cytokines, okay? Pre-treatment with cytokines. These cytokines, okay, these cytokines like your granulocyte colony stimulating factor, okay, they induce the release of your granulocyte from the bone marrow, okay? From the bone marrow. So, other sources pa ng stem cell natin can also be your umbilical cord. Ayan, your umbilical cord. Kaya, di ba, remember, whenever meron tayong whenever may pinapanganak, they are collecting stem cell through the umbilical cord, okay? Through the umbilical cord. And aside from that, for experimental purposes naman, you can actually have you can actually gather the hematopoietic stem cell from fetal liver, fetal spleen, and the aorta, gonad, mesonephros. The AGM, what phase of hematopoiesis is this? Anyone? Sige nga, I hope may makasagot.
Sir?
Anong phase ng hematopoiesis pag nasa aorta, gonad, mesonephros? What phase of hematopoiesis? May sumasagot ba sa ano? Okay, correct. May sumasagot na pala dito. It is your mesoblastic phase, correct. Sa mesoblastic phase po siya. Okay? So, this is for animals, ha? For experimental purposes only. Okay? So, ayan siya. So, you can see, medyo malabo lang. Pero these are the hematopoietic stem cell. Sir, pa, how can I differentiate it? Actually, you cannot differentiate it. Visually, you cannot differentiate your... we cannot differentiate them from the other. Okay? We cannot differentiate which one is the myeloid and which one is the lymphoid. Okay? So, let's go now to the difference ng stem cell. Okay? So, functional characteristic of your stem cell, they are multipotency and they can do self-renewal. Okay? It has their own ability to form multiple cell types. Okay? Multipotency and their ability to self-renew is attributed to this characteristic of your stem cell. So, your hematopoietic stem cell can also expand to generate very large amount of progeny cell. Okay? So, when we say progeny cell in the hematopoietic stem cell, so these are now your colony, yung myeloid progeny natin, colony of myeloid progeny, and then your CLP, which is now for your lymphoid on the other hand, okay? Which is for the lymphoid. So, let's just finish this one. Ayan, I think, hindi ko sure kung matatapos ko yung erythropoiesis mamaya, but I'll just try to explain something pa kasi later. Okay, so hematopoietic stem cell, okay? So their mobility naman, let's talk about their mobility. So hematopoietic stem cell have higher potential than other immature blood cell. So immature blood cells to pass the bone marrow barrier. So your hematopoietic stem cell may travel in the blood from the bone marrow. Okay? Pwede 'yon. So aside from that, your hematopoietic stem cell can travel from one bone to another bone. So, if they settle on the thymus, okay, take for example, if your hematopoietic stem cell settled on the thymus, they will now develop into your T cells. Okay, and this is the answer in your quiz. It's just your thymus. Some of you answered thymus, nilagay nyo na lahat para sure, but that is incorrect. Okay? It's only your thymus. Okay? Your thymus, your thymus give rise to your T cell. Ayan. So, let me just share to you my screen once more. Okay. Let me just share to you my screen once more para makita ninyo yung ano. Okay? Okay, can you guys see my screen right now? Hello?
Yes, po, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ayan. Okay, I'm actually using your raw doc here right now. Okay? So, this is actually seen in page 55. Okay? Page 55. So, take for example, this is your stem cell. Okay? This is your hematopoietic stem cell. I'll draw na lang another one. Okay, this is, take for example, your hematopoietic stem cell. Okay? This is your hematopoietic stem cell. Sabi natin kanina, it can give rise to two daughter cells. One that will undergo what? Undergo self-renewal, or the other one, okay? The other one can differentiate into becoming your pluripotent hematopoietic stem cell. And as you can see here, guys, okay, as you can see here, there are particular cytokines that influence it, okay? That influence it. So take for example, this is the HSC, sabi natin kanina, okay? Yung process ng pagpunta niya, if whether it is going to renew or differentiate, it is stochastic, okay? Are we clear? It is stochastic. But the process now, because of this, okay, I hope nakikita nyo ha, yung mga kit ligand natin, this one, can you see the things that I am highlighting right now? Those FL3 kit ligand, those are your cytokines that influences the differentiation that is now called your instructive. Clear tayo? We call that instructive hematopoiesis. Are we clear? Instructive na po yan. Yes. Okay, ito stochastic. Ibig sabihin, random lang siyang nangyayari. Ito naman, instructive na po. Okay, sabi din natin kanina, okay, sabi natin kanina, okay, there are two, yung CLP at yung CL, yung progeny natin, okay, yung progeny natin can become your common lymphoid progenitor or your common myeloid progenitor and your common lymphoid progenitor. Tanggalin natin, ibahin natin yung color. Okay? Sabi ni sir kanina, yung common myeloid precursor natin, okay? Yung common myeloid precursor natin will give rise to your gem. And what is that? What are those gem that we are talking about kanina? Those are actually your what? Your granulocytes. Okay? Okay, tanggalin ko yung isa ha kasi just for the sake of accuracy. Your granulocytes. Okay, which is your eosinophil, basophil, and your neutrophil. Okay, we also have here, okay, your letter E. Sabi doon, ano yung E? That is your erythrocyte. The other M here is your monocyte. Okay, your monocyte or even your mast cell. So interchangeably, okay, monocyte or your mast cell. And the other M is your megakaryocyte that will give rise to your platelets. Nakikita po ninyo, so from your common myeloid precursor, it can give rise now to four. It can become your granulocyte, your granulocyte, your eobaso, which will be discussed in the leukopoiesis eventually, and we also have here your megakaryocyte erythrocyte precursor. Okay? So nagigets niyo po ako, yung common myeloid po natin, pwede it can become your granulocytes, your erythrocytes, your megakaryocytes and your monocyte and your mast cell. On the other hand, okay, what about your common lymphoid precursor? Your common lymphoid precursor, very simple. It can only become two types of cell. If I am going to be more specific, okay, those two type of cell is actually just your lymphocytes and your natural killer cell. But if we're gonna be more specific, okay, your common lymphoid precursor can become your dendritic cell, your pre-beta, your pre-B cell, and your pre-T cell, and your natural killer cells. Okay, natural killer cells, your common lymphoid precursor, if it mature. Okay, your common lymphoid precursor, if it went to your, kunwari, pumunta siya sa thymus mo, okay, pumunta siya sa thymus mo, it will be following this path. But if it is in the bone marrow, it will be following this path. Are we clear? So yun lang naman yung gusto kong makita ninyo, okay? That is what I want you guys to see, okay? That your common myeloid precursor, your common lymphoid precursor, will give rise to your gem, and this one will give rise to your lympho and your NK cells. Okay, when I say lympho, we have here your B and your T cells. Are we clear? Clear po tayo?
Yes po, sir.
What about the others? Clear ba tayo? Guys, ganito ha. If things are not clear with you, hindi naman ako nangangain ng buhay, okay? Lalo na kayo, hindi ko naman kayo abot kamay, di ba? So, kung may hindi clear, magsabi na agad, okay? Para hindi na lumalaki ang maliit na problema, okay? Are we clear? Hindi ako napuputol. Sino ba yung mga madalas mag-shopee? Naga, are we clear? Masiglat?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Abenyeta, are we clear? Hello? Okay. Clear. Okay? So actually, yun yung hematopoietic stem cell. Okay? So kung ako sa inyo, okay, when you do, ganito ko siya i-review kung ako sa inyo. I will just draw. So meron akong stem cell, tapos naging dalawa siya, di ba? I'm just trying to wrap it up na ha, para ma-reinforce natin. Okay? So ulitin natin guys, okay? I will just be sending you the erythropoiesis para mas ano. Actually, ano lang naman na yun? Mabilis na lang naman yung sa erythropoiesis. Okay? So, take for example, nandito na tayo sa ano. Nandito na tayo sa part na to. So, I have two. Okay? Sabi natin kanina. Okay? So, let me just try to be artistic as possible. Okay? If these two cell, okay, differentiate, okay? If these two cell differentiate, we call it symmetric. Sorry, pangit talaga sulat ko. We call it symmetric. But, okay, pangit ang sulat. Sorry. No OC lang ako. Okay. Ayan. Pag nag-differentiate siya. But if one differentiate, okay, nag-differentiate, the other one went back to the pool, okay, renewal, we call that your what? Asymmetric. Okay? Kaklaruhin ko guys ha, I want you to remember that this is the reason why hindi nauubos yung inyong stem cell. Sabi, inisip niyo siguro, hala kung, di ba, yung mga counts natin kanina, 1 billion, 2.5 billion of erythrocyte and platelet, hindi ba nauubos, sir? Yun siguro yung tanong nyo. Hindi. Because it can go self-renewal. Okay? And, okay, in this particular process, sabihin na natin, di ba? In this particular process na tinatawag natin kanina, okay? In this particular part here, okay? Itong particular part na to ng ating mga cell, okay? Ay undergoing stochastic, okay? So, anong ibig sabihin ng stochastic? Ibig sabihin, random po yan. It can randomly go symmetric or randomly go asymmetric. Are we clear? Okay, sana clear. Hindi niyo ako sinasagot.
Yes po.
Okay. So, take for example, ngayon, nag-differentiate na siya. Okay? It differentiated now into becoming your common myeloid precursor and your common lymphoid precursor. I will just be explaining the simple part, ha? Guys, please review the cytokines, the colony stimulating factors. Okay? Sabi ni sir kanina, meron daw cytokines. Okay? May cytokines that influences the proliferation, the differentiation, and the maturation of cell either positively or negatively on this particular part now of the process. Okay? In this particular part of the process, ano na tong nangyayari dito? This particular part here, okay, later on, hanggang matapos to, we call that now, what? We call that your, ano to? Kung yung kanina stochastic, anong tawag ko dapat dito?
Instructive, sir.
Instructive. Correct. Okay, this is your instructive hematopoiesis. Whereby, okay, there will be some colony stimulating factors, your, colony stimulating factors, cytokines, that will influence now your colony, your common myeloid precursor, and your common lymphoid precursor to further differentiate. So this one can become your granulocyte. Okay, it can become your granulocyte, your erythrocytes, your MAC, or your mast cell, and your megakaryocyte. On the other hand, this one will give rise to your B cell if it mature on your bone marrow, your T cell, it be if it is in your thymus and your NK cells. Okay? Your NK cells. So, yung diniscuss ko po mula kanina, actually, majority of those are already here in this diagram. Okay? So, hopefully, kapag nag-review, medyo mas maging madali na po for you. Okay, I still have 15 minutes. Do you have any questions with regards to everything that I discussed today? If you have, please raise them now. Huwag may yung magtanong. That silence ba means you understood everything or nahihiya lang magtanong? Hello?
Sir, yes. Question po. Hmm. Yung D1 and D2 po, is it kaparehas po lang nung HSC po?
Yes, oo. Parang ano to, JM, nagmanipulis siya. So, okay. When you say daughter cell, parehas lang ni mother.
Question, sir. Di ba po may certain cytokines po na nag-influence ng differentiation? So, kailangan po ba lahat ng cytokines na yun present for it to be a common myeloid progenitor? Like yung kanina pong pinakita nyo, may IL-1, IL-6. Ito po, yung mga naka-highlight.
Okay, buburahin ko lang ha. Ito. Okay, ito ba yung sinasabi ko? Ayan. Yes, so, sabi natin kanina, di ba, na after differentiation, dun na actually nag-start yung instructive hematopoiesis. When we say instructive, there are cytokines coming from the bone marrow microenvironment that will influence when will they become one or the other. Sir, kailangan ba ito lahat nandun? Yes. Okay? So ito, kung mapapansin nyo, this one is very, the kit ligand, the interleukin 136 are very, ano siya, para siyang common. Okay? Common siya. So, ito, it instructs now the differentiation. So, kung makikita mo dito, it is your FL3 ligand and your KIT ligand and your interleukin 7 that will influence your pluripotent stem cell into becoming your common lymphoid progenitor. Dito naman, itong mga to, okay, palitan natin ng kulay para hindi kayo malito. This one naman, okay, the FL3 ligand, KIT ligand, GM, your GM colony stimulating factor, your interleukin 1, 3, 6, 11, they will give rise to your common myeloid progenitor. Maybe some of you are wondering, sir, anong ibig sabihin ng FL3 ng KIT sa KIT ligand? These are actually gene. Okay? Nandun na siya sa gene, which will now lead me dun sa, saan na bang part yun? Which will now lead me dun sa multi-lineage na priming model. Okay? Dun naman siya galing sa gene. Gets?
Gets po, sir. Thank you po.
So, kunwari, tuloy ko yung tanong ni JM, no? Kunwari, ang na-release po, mga kapatid, ang na-release within your bone marrow are this factor. Kung mapapansin nyo, medyo redundant. But, it will now different, yung mga minor na differences nila, yun yung nagpapaiba. Okay? So makikita nyo dito, yung granulocyte monocyte progenitor, your eosinophil basophil progenitor. It is your KIT ligand, tas yung interleukin 3, tas yung interleukin 3 and 5, iba yung ipoproduce. Ito yung gusto kong makita rin yung isa pa. Okay? Are you guys seeing this? The megakaryocyte, erythrocyte progenitor?
Yes po, sir.
Ayan. So, diba, from a common progenitor, it by the influence of your FL3, yung FLT3 ligand natin, yung CM, colony stimulating factor, it will now become your megakaryocyte erythrocyte progenitor. A big question sa inyo siguro, sir, paano po malalaman ni cell kung kailangan niya maging erythrocyte? Paano niya po malalaman kung kailangan niya po maging thrombocytes or platelets? Doon na ngayon papasok, natatandaan ninyo, yung tinatawag nating mga hormones. Si erythropoietin at saka si thrombopoietin. Okay? Si thrombopoietin, later on ko pa dapat i-discuss eh. Pero thrombopoietin, tandaan nyo na lang, baka lumabas pa sa exam. Thrombopoietin. Okay? This is your erythropoietin. Okay? So, balik ako. So, kapag meron po tayong erythropoietin, sasabihin niya, okay, megakaryocyte erythrocyte progenitor. I am EPO, I need more red blood cells. So, doon siya ngayon, magiging pronormoblast. Ito, kulang to ha, pero shortcut to. Magiging erythrocyte na siya ngayon. Nagigets? Pag naman si TPO ang nag-interact kay megakaryocyte erythrocyte progenitor natin, it will influence the cell into becoming your megakaryoblast, your megakaryocyte, and eventually your platelets. Are we clear? So nakikita nyo ngayon yung point ko sa instructive na may mga cytokines that influences a particular cell into becoming that specific cell na kailangan. Are we clear?
Yes po. Sir?
Go.
Yung thrombopoietin po ba, hormone din po siya? Saan po siya galing?
Created by the liver.
Okay po.
Pasulat na lang ha. Yung thrombopoietin natin, hormone secreted by the liver. Si erythropoietin, a hormone secreted by what organ? Chat box. Okay, correct. It is by your kidneys. Okay, tatandaan nyo yun ha. Bakit ko paulit-ulit tinatanong? Kasi if you're going to, kung I don't know if you realize, no? But one important thing, okay, parang lahat connected naman, si spleen, si liver, pero ba't may naliligaw kay kidney? Okay? So, ito, I don't know kung mag-grasp nyo, makukuha nyo pa yung idea. Pero dun kasi sa kidneys ninyo, nandun yun yung pinaka-sensitive na nakaka-detect kung may hypoxia. What is hypoxia? Kulang sa oxygen. Okay? Si kidney, nade-detect na, ay, kulang sa oxygen. O, lalabas ngayon si erythropoietin. Okay? Napupunta sa bone marrow. Ganun siya. Actually, in HEMA, actually, makakatulong sa inyo yung pagdodrawing ninyo kung paano nangyayari yung bagay-bagay. Okay? Kasi doon nyo mas masosolidify yung topics na alam ninyo. Okay? So, clear na ba tayo? Ha? So, ganun okay. Sa common lymphoid precursor. Okay? So, dahil sinabi ko na rin kanina, di ba? Mamaya kasi, hopefully, okay, medyo jam-packed tong Friday ko ngayon, pero I'll try na matapos mamayang madaling araw yung part ng erythropoiesis para mabigay ko sa inyo over ng Friday. Okay? So, ano
sir,
po ba?
Question po.
Go.
With all the diagrams po, ano po yung kailangan naming i-memorize or i-review po?
With all the diagrams that are here?
Opo.
For me, ha, sa erythropoiesis kasi, mamaya, meron kasi yung tatlong, ito kasi nakita nyo dito, shortcut to. Merong pronormoblast, tapos merong normoblast. Merong iba-iba pa siyang stage, which is actually here sa chapter. Ito. Ito yung susunod na i-discuss ko eh. Ito. Siguro ito yung isa na kailangan nyo i-memorize. Yung pronormoblast. Yan. Ito. Ito yung isang kailangan nyo i-memorize. Actually, di naman yung diagram. Actually, kahit ito lang i-memorize nyo. Ito. Yung mga names. Yun na siya. Siguro yung point ko lang, JM, na sinasabi kong diagram, mas maiintindihan nyo kasi, mas maiintindihan ninyo yung, ito, parang ito, mas maiintindihan nyo yung point ko ng stochastic, ng asymmetric, kapag may diagram. ano niya siya?
Yes po, sir.
So, parang pag binasa mo lang, okay, ito yung stochastic, random. Okay, parang sometimes kasi we need to visualize. Ako kasi visual ako. I don't know yung iba sa inyo, baka carry nyo naman na siya. Pero ayan nga, ayan. So yung sina, ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina na itong part na to. Ayan. So, may tanong pa?
Sir?
Yes, Kit.
Kit, sir, pwede yeah. po paulit yung ano, yung kung saan po nag-o-occur yung multi-lineage priming model. Yung dun po sa kanina po, yung diagram, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yung multi-lineage kasi, unang-una, yung multi-lineage natin is governed by your genes, okay? Sabi natin kanina yung mga genes. Yung mga genes na yan, they will either repress or suppress or amplify, okay? Amplify. Mapapansin kanina, 'di ba, sabi ko, si FL3 at si Kit Ligand are actually yung production nila are influenced by your genes. So Kit, yung instructive at yung multi-lineage model natin, they overlap. Nagigets po ako? So parang ganito siya. Di ba sabi ko kanina yung instructive natin is because of the bone marrow micro environment. Okay? Nakukuha. So sila yung instructive. But if we're gonna dig deeper dito sa tawag dito sa topic na to, okay, sa topic na to, there are internal and external factors that will now influence din si microenvironment. So parang si multi-lineage mo dito, okay, ito si internal and external factors, okay. Internal factors, I mean the gene. External factor, what I mean by there is your physiologic factors na. So, parang si multi-lineage, they also influence your bone marrow microenvironment. Hello?
Thank you, sir.
Clear ba?
Opo, sir. Thank you.
Again? So parang yung instructive mo at saka si multi-lineage, they overlap. Ayun.
Thank you po, sir.
Okay. So any question pa? May tanong pa po? Di na pa pong may tanong. Go lang, tanong na, guys. Hello? Hello po.
I think, sir, wala naman po ata since wala naman na po ata.
Okay. So if you don't have any questions now, ayan, siguro by tonight, I'll send the PowerPoint with voiceover na lang. Okay? So, and I'll stop the recording na. Just like what I told you guys yesterday, give me feedback